J.K. Callaway here with Siobhan, jumping back into Wednesday. And we're on the back half of the season one, episode five. It's called You Reap What You Woe. We'll see what that means. But last episode, yeah, there's a bunch of things that happened. Like the dance, which we heard she choreographed it herself. And that's kind of the charm of it, because you can tell. Like, it wasn't, like, all professional and shit. It was just cool. Mm-hmm. And it fit the character perfectly. Mm. It's beautiful. You have to start doing the wavy hands and that. You have to start doing it. Broken just neck. Every once in a while, just broken neck. Just every once in a while. But also, Eugene died. Which sucks. But I see that coming from a mile away. But there are questions, because we've seen the Gollum thing. Not only, like, with Wednesday, but also that moody kid who used to be popular, I don't know, that keeps on thinking there's a thing between him and Wednesday, whatever. His drawings. He can make his drawings come to life. And he's been drawing that golem a lot. You know, can he control his power? Because we see him control it with that spider at the beginning of the series. You know? But why would he want to hurt people? What's the point? Especially
he said he was drawing it because it was in his dreams and he was trying to get it out.
He can say whatever he wants.
So
he can say anything. Doesn't mean shit. But okay. I don't know. We'll see. Like, I originally thought it was Ricci. Now I think it's guaranteed to be one of his drawings. We just don't know. Maybe one of his drawings got out on accident.
But and then it's they still turn out into human?
Yeah, we saw the footsteps, didn't we? No, it's Ricci. I win. No idea. There's so many options. Well, we saw Eugene get ripped up, and it seems like, Wednesday found him. But shortly thereafter, Ricci walks up, and her first question was, is he still alive? Not, are you okay? Is he okay? Did you do this? No, it was, is he still alive? As if Ricci did it. No, she did it. Couldn't control herself because she's Gollum Ricci. She played that one movie with the pig nose. She's able to shift.
Penelope.
She's able to shapeshift. We know this. More so than the principal.
If you haven't seen Penelope, it's adorable.
It's a good movie. She's got a pig nose. She was also in Buffalo 66 with Vincent Gallo. That was a giant piece of shit. But so was Vincent Gallo, so. The late 90s were weird.
She's in Black Snake Moan.
That was a great movie. Timberlake's in that movie, and he did great.
Mm-hmm.
Despite himself. Plus, they have lots of sex. She's a nymphomaniac in that movie. So it's a great movie. So we'll jump back in. Hopefully there's more dancing. But there's lots of other fun stuff going on, too. So, yeah, it's been fun. And we got four left. Here we go.
How well do we really know our parents? Take my father. I've always considered him an open book, but when he was a student, he was accused of a murder that took place right up there.
Like what?
Which leads me to wonder.
Ooh, goth and glamour.
Stormy night, 13 years ago. Mm-hmm.
Oh, she found him too, huh? Oh.
But it's all Morticia Frump's fault. They were fighting over her.
Okay.
Seeing you in handcuffs, accused of murder. I've never loved you more.
All right, that's enough, Adam.
To be fair, the actor playing Gomez looks like he's killed so many people.
I knew I should have worn my plague mask. To look at my family. Talk about toxic pack mentality.
Oh, how we missed those accusing eyes and youthful sneer.
Since you've abandoned me here, I've been hunted, haunted, and the target of an attempted murder.
Ah, nevermore. I love you so.
My darling daughter.
Uh-oh. Who is it?
I made it.
Yeah, I don't know.
Wouldn't miss this for the world.
She seems very afraid of Mom.
Do you remember when we did that duet for the Solstice Talent Show?
Your Judy Garland impression was a dead ringer.
Dr. Kimbert and I have spoken, and we both agree it would be most beneficial for you all to attend a family session this weekend.
Ooh. No.
I've always been a big fan of head shrinking.
It's not that kind of head shrinking, mon chéri.
Well, that is disappointing. But anything for our little girl.
I mean, for me, it's been hard not having one stay around. I never thought I'd miss being waterboarded so much.
I think it's high time my parents faced the music.
Uh-oh.
It seems they've been lying to me, keeping secrets.
Those charges were dropped. Your father's an innocent man.
Local sheriff doesn't seem too convinced.
Wednesday, stop.
If you refuse to tell me the truth, I'll just have to excavate it myself.
Oh.
Thanks for the candy.
Actually, that's potpourri.
Okay.
Why don't you take the bowl?
How could you ambush your father like that? Wednesday!
How could I? You insisted I go to this school. Did you really think I wouldn't find out your secret?
Potpourri?
I thought it was apple chips.
Morning Song community misses you. I miss you.
And by community, you mean cults.
I haven't come here to fight, Brandy Jane.
My name is Bianca. New name, new life.
It's time to come home.
That place was never my home.
My siren song is drying up. Recruitment numbers are way down and the wrong people are starting to ask questions.
Oh.
And if I refuse?
Then everybody here's gonna know how you sirened your way into Nevermore. You got until the end of the weekend to say your goodbyes.
Oh.
Garrett, I take it?
We need to tell her.
She'll never believe us. We must stay strong.
Have you wolfed out yet?
Right.
No.
That is a disappointment.
That's me.
How can I help you, Sheriff? You're under arrest for the murder of Garrett Gates. Either write your name silent, anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. Garrett was infatuated with your mother. He mistook her kindness for interest. He started stalking her.
Why didn't you call the police?
We tried. But his family were the oldest and richest in Jericho. No one believed us. He had broken into the school. His twisted love for his mother had made him insane. His eyes bore into me, brimming with murderous intent. I saw the sword. My survival instinct kicked in.
Why was he
foaming at the mouth?
Literally?
Yeah.
It was a terrible accident.
Maybe.
But then there's the matter of his tells. The way he smooths his mustache. The way he delivers a comforting wink. I've been playing Russian roulette with him since I was 12. I know them well.
Garrett Gates' family deserves closure, even if none of them are around to take comfort in it.
What happened to them?
His mother hung herself in the backyard, his father drank himself to an early grave, and even his little sister didn't escape, ended up drowning. Every last one of them's gone.
Jesus.
So your father doesn't just have Garrett's blood on his hands, he's got the whole damn family's.
Hello, Mother.
Hello, Wednesday. So you're a nightshade.
Actually, I rejected them.
Why? Because I was a member?
I'll never live up to your legacy here. Father didn't kill Garrett Gates, did he?
Uh-oh.
No.
She was Garrett's fencing team.
He was even foaming at the mouth. It was like I was staring into the eyes of a rabid beast.
You walked right into it.
Your father was so calm and brave.
You need to leave right now. Go to your room and lock the door. You would never hear. Do you understand me?
Your father took the blame in order to protect me.
You said Garrett was foaming at the mouth. His eyes didn't look human.
I've never seen someone so blinded by rage.
What are those all textbook symptoms of?
Poisoning?
Rabies?
No. What flower? It's more self-defense than anything. Ew. Took a big old whiff.
He died from nightshade poisoning. The remarkable preservation of soft tissue and blue tint confirms it.
Which means Garrett was dying
before you stabbed him.
Prove to me you're still worthy to be called my son! Kill all those outcasts!
Mom's gonna notice.
Did you have a vision?
Yup.
What happened? What did you see?
That blue sheen is a telltale sign of nightshade poisoning.
But you already knew that, didn't you? Because back when you were sheriff, you were in charge of the case and covered it up.
Ansel confessed the whole thing to me in a drunken stupor. It was his idea.
Why did you instruct Dr. Anwar to falsify the autopsy report? You knew the truth.
I remember Garrett bragging to me that his father had the sheriff in his pocket. 1 year later, you get elected mayor. All charges dropped.
My father will be released immediately with a full and unequivocal apology from the sheriff's office.
When did your visions begin?
A few months ago. Sometimes when I touch someone or something, I get these very violent glimpses from the past or future. I don't know how to control it.
My visions tend to be positive. That makes me a dove.
For someone like me? Who sees the world through a darker lens?
You're a raven. If I could help you, I would, Wednesday. But we're not trained by the living. Somebody from our bloodline reaches out from beyond to help us when we're ready.
Dad!
I just hope that one day you'll finally be able to accept me for who I am.
Hell yeah.
I'm proud of you, kiddo. You do you.
I'll come back and help you under one condition. Wait until the school year is over. But after this, you and Morning Song are out of my life. Forever.
I knew you didn't have what it takes to be a murderer.
As much as that stings. Gracias, my little death trap.
If you need me for anything, anything at all, I'm only a crystal ball away.
When Roman appeared the next morning, it was you. You see, when you participated in the talent show with my mother, not only did you impersonate Judy Garland, you became her. You're a shapeshifter.
You won't tell a soul, Miss Adams.
And it wouldn't matter much if you did. Roan's father already knows what happened, and he fully supports my decision not to involve the authorities.
I did what I needed to do to shield the school from controversy and protect its students from harm.
Tell that to Eugene. How are you protecting him?
What on earth?
Fire will rain? Is it depressing that I read that as, like, fire someone named Will Rain? I'm sitting there like, who the fuck's Will Rain? What did he do? It's one way to get someone fired, I'm just saying.
And they used R-A-I-N, right?
What?
It was R-A-I-N, not R-E-I-G-N. Like, rain.
No, they're not going to start worshipping fire.
Correct. No. I just wanted to make sure, because I sometimes do that, where I flip.
Right.
So, it's going to... lots of
fall from the sky.
Yes.
So they cleared up the whole Gomez is a murderer thing pretty quick. I thought that would be a more of a major, like, you know, maybe even throughout the entire series kind of...
Right.
You know, mystery. But no, they just... All right, Nightshade. But who would have given him Nightshade? Well, where would his dad have gotten Nightshade, right?
Well, if they were the oldest residents of the town...
There would have been someone.
Like...
Right? Like, regular old humans would figure out what Nightshade does, not just...
Right, but...
You know, but...
If they're the oldest in the town, I could see that they're... Their family has a outcast that nobody would know about, and they
maybe.
You know, use that, like.
Mm-hmm. And then we did
it's okay
see,
for them.
Right? Of course, do as I say, not as I do. But also, the sheriff was looking at that picture, right, of the dead kid and then his parents
that was
and
the mayor,
daughter,
but yes.
Mayor. Sorry, but I feel like they're hinting at the fact that maybe the sister's still alive.
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
Don't know who that could be, because that was quite a while ago. Like, it wouldn't be Richie. And it wouldn't be the principal, because she was...
It could be Richie.
How young was that? Like, she didn't look much younger.
That was a child that was 11 or 12.
Mm-hmm. Yes, but Richie is 17 years old in this show. And clearly, if they... graduated in 1990, then they're 8 years older than me, so they're 50, right?
But she said 13 years ago. I don't think this show is set in 2022. I think it's set in early 2000s.
Who knows? But I don't know. So I'm just being silly. It could be Richie. And she certainly knows about Nightshade. Not that she would have given him the Nightshade when she was a kid, but she would know about it.
She might.
She teaches a class.
I'm sorry, she might have given it to
okay.
him.
Okay. I was like, yeah, she knows about it. So maybe she's also the golem. Maybe she went off and learned how to be a golem. I don't know. She's got a big role to play, that's all I know. They wouldn't bring in Richie just to be some very, very, very attractive teacher. Which is apparently my jam. You get some Lisa Loeb glasses on you and I'm done. Oh.
I wore my blue light glasses the other day because I had a headache.
Sure. Did I destroy you at the time? Because I
should've... I was at work.
You call
but
me
my,
when that happens
my
next
My students
time.
Were all very confused. Do you wear glasses? No, I don't.
Oh. That'd be the easiest Christmas present for you. Doesn't even need to be prescriptions. Just get some Lisa Loeb glasses on you. And nothing else.
I can't.
Merry Christmas to me.
I
more of a birthday thing.
So she has the cat eye glasses, right?
Who?
Lisa Loeb.
Yes.
I wonder if I can buy a blue light
cat eye glasses?
Yeah.
That's just a level of nerdy. I don't know if it exists currently. You might have to start a trend. But we got to see a lot of Morticia. We got to see them talk about their visions a little bit. How apparently... the way to learn how to control them is to be contacted by a ghost? Mm-hmm. Okay.
Well, and that Morticia's a dove.
Right.
And her visions are light.
Also, like, how in the world is Morticia a dove? Like, she's still dark. Like, she's got dark sensibility. Like, she's got the same sensibilities as Wednesday, right? Just, like, Morticia's an optimist, Wednesday's a pessimist. That's the only difference.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like, Morticia's... ripping heads off of roses and, like, trimming the heads off of roses in the movie, which was great. Seriously, they have the same sensibility. They both have dark sensibilities. You know? They might have different ways of looking at things as far as, like, this might work out versus this might not, but I don't know. Wednesdays are people. We don't think anything good's going to happen in this world. And we also think we're smarter than everyone else. Yeah, thank you guys for watching. Comments. Let us know what you thought of that one. I thought it was fun. Got a lot of backstory. I like the fact that the child Gomez also had, like, just the gigantic bridge that Louise has. It's funny. But yeah, it was good. And three left. We'll see where it goes. Yeah, thank you guys for watching. We appreciate you. We'll talk to you next time.
Juice.
She was holding a cup. Well planned.